hang on a sec, let me sort this dumbass laptop out. This is painful. I don't even know if it's working. My internet is so shit. This might not even be worth doing. Anyway, alright everybody, how goes it? I hope you're all well. I hope you can see me. I hope you can hear me. According to that, you can't. I don't know. But we're going to stream it anyway. See what happens. If it's crap, I'll delete it. And that'll be my streaming. I like to do a full weekend and stream a full weekend race. Just for the crack. But then I remembered that I'm halfway through a single career and we're at Zandvoort anyway. So I did actually try to change the weekend to a full weekend, which is what I usually like to do. But it wouldn't let me. So we're on a 35% race. We've actually got Quali 2 and 3 to do. Well, hopefully 3. Fingers crossed. We've made it into Q. We've made it through Q1. So, let's get into Q2. I believe the setup should be already in. Because I think it saves it from when you were last logged in. We're in Parc Fermé anyway, so hopefully it's the setup that I put in earlier. So that must be Q1. So in theory, in the time trial that I did a while ago, we are capable of exactly 1 second quicker than the time that we've got there. We should be able to do an 11.8, which would get me on pole. Have I used two sets of tyres? That's not good. Let's put them ones on. Right. Hey, there's not much time left. What's the crack there?
Right, the car's ready. Let's get it out there.
Oh no, hang on a minute. Have I already done my lap? Oh, we'll go out and do another one anyway. Get dialed in a bit.
A few lap outs yet, but it is coming, so be careful.
Rain? That's not good. So this is my team and my car. We started from scratch originally, and as you can tell, we're on the Zandvoort track. So I think that's, is it six or seven races in? I can't remember. So the car's not fully developed, and it's certainly not the quickest on the grid. So we can only do what we can do. Let's see what happens here. Get out of my way. But yeah, we must be, I haven't realised, but we are halfway, well, it's finished now actually, Q2. Let's remind ourselves of where the pit entry is and the timing line. I know it's very tight entry. So we're further on than I thought. So I must have, last time I was on here, I must have saved it halfway through Q2. Cheers, by the way. Don't drink and drive, kids. Do as I say, not as I do. So we should have got through there. Seventh, yeah, so we're into Q3. Ding dang do. I'm doing a lot better in single career than I am in the co-op career that I'm doing with a mate of mine. I think there's four. Right, let's just check we've got a new set of boots on. Oh no, it's raining. Really? Where's the weather report? Is it going to dry up? It's going to dry up. Well, stop raining. In 5 minutes. I say, we go and get a banker lap in anyway, just in case it doesn't dry up properly.
Everyone ready? Okay, let's go.
I hope it's going to be dry for the race, I didn't check the weather. Half the time when it puts you on intermediate tyres, that to me looks like a bloody wet track. And of course we're driving with zero assists. Slippy. Not much grip at all. As you can see. Of course, because we're in Parc Fermé, this is a dry setup. Very slippy. So unless it dries up, I can't see this going well. 122s they're doing. It's difficult enough track in the dry with it being quite tight turns, so in the wet it's even worse, which is pretty obvious to say. But how long's left? 7 minutes, so in 2 minutes in theory it should be dry. It's not going to dry up enough to put slicks on, surely.
Okay,
no grip at all. Give over. Where'd that put me? Seventh. Oh, bugger. Seventh. Can I return to the pits? Yeah. Should be dry by now.
I'd take a set of intermediates in these unpredictable conditions.
Right, so it hasn't dried up. It's not drying up. We're gonna go again, we're gonna have to go now.
All clear the garage, please. Car's ready to leave.
We're only gonna get one.
ETA on this rain clearing up is about 10 minutes, so just keep your concentration out there, you're doing well.
That's not what it said on the screen. Alright, let's see what we can do.
Just 30 seconds left in the session.
Whoa. We've got gone all Vin Diesel.
Are you okay? That was a nasty hit. Turn the engine off and wait for the marshals.
Oh, it's going to flashback, isn't it? Not going to improve, are we? A little bit. P10. That's dull. That's dull. Hopefully the race is dry. I didn't see the weather report.
We're all ready for tomorrow's race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look.
It's not going to be easy coming through the pack here. Verstappen,
Russell, and Carlos Sainz.
I see flashbacks being the ace of the day. Horse is around 14, just over halfway. Alright, what have they got to say? The strategy for this race is just like any other. Nail the start. Lead out of turn one. You're joking, I'm in 10th place. Win by miles. Any questions? Quite a few actually. Failing that, keep your wits about you and everything will be just fine. I believe we have the pace for a good result here, so we're going to put the ERS up for the start, get a good launch, and take it one corner at a time from there. Well, you're not wrong. Ah, but it is going to be sunny. Ding dang do. So yeah, like I say, I usually try and do a full weekend when I can, when it's the actual real life race weekend. But as I say, we were halfway through doing Zandvoort on single career. So I thought, oh, I may as well just finish this, especially with the internet being so crap. You're probably unlikely to have got this far into the stream. Into the video. So if you have, kudos, well done, and thank you very much.
Welcome along then to the North Sea coast and to the Zandvoort circuit. We're 25 miles away from Amsterdam for today's Dutch Grand Prix.
It's a Amsterdam. Race, Jim Clark won many happy memories.
Leading for an astonishing total of 370 laps. To take a look at our starting grid for today's race. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday and he'll start from pole position, just ahead of George Russell, who starts this event from P2.
I don't know what my lap time was actually. It can't have been very good. It must have been Hamilton, 23 or something.
Norris, Leclerc, Fernando Alonso, Bottas, Surfer Boy, Oscar Piastri,
23, Ocon, yeah.
Hülkenberg, Perez, Magnussen, Albon,
Which in theory it wasn't a bad time really, considering it was wet. You can roughly add 10 seconds when it's wet.
That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head down trackside for today's race.
When you're ready.
After the points finished last race, let's aim to keep that momentum going.
Yeah, we got second in the last race. Right, what are we doing? Gotta be softs, mediums. Is it worth editing it? Just bar one lap. Yeah, that'll ding dang do. Right, let's get into it.
We're not seeing any technical issues coming off the practice starts. Watch the RPM on the full start. We don't want you to bog down.
So it's not going to be easy to pass people here. It's mainly going to be done on the straight. And if we're lucky, into turn one from the start. But it never usually ends well for me when I try that. I always set out with the intention of not using flashbacks.
Radar is clear, weather is looking good for now.
Bit of play in my brake pedal as well for some reason. Was I on the left? Yeah.
Drivers, as the lights go out.
Well, at least we know how to park.
Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid is formed. Be ready with a.
Whoa. I think we'll start that again, eh?
The safety car might be deployed if there's an incident or the
give over. I'll do. Doing.
Okay, now stay alert for threats around you.
Oh. Well, that was a decent first lap in the end. They're pulling away though, aren't they?
Second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone.
Take a totally different line there, don't they? I think I'm taking the ACC line. Come on, Dottie. Come on, car. Not quite close enough. Of course, the car isn't fully developed yet, so a lot of these guys are quicker than us anyway. Even with DRS and... Should get him now, surely. Rubin's racing. Four seconds away now from the next guy.
Okay, gap to the car ahead is 4.0 seconds.
I just said that. He's going to have DRS now, Bottas. Time for me to get my elbows out. Need to recoup some energy though, so hopefully he won't be that close.
There's a new strategy available on the MFD.
The strategies we've got are right, don't worry about it.
Behind, really good stuff.
No, we're not, we've only just overtaken him. I mean, we are pulling away from him, but we're not catching P7. Bloody Piastri.
Okay, here's the gap that we're trailing the car ahead by. 5.8 seconds. Green flag.
What happened?
Here's some information on Hülkenberg. Oh. They're retiring from the race.
Is he in front? Yeah, he was. Was he? No, he wasn't. I think I'm pitting this lap, aren't I?
Yellow flag. Okay, be aware there's an incident in the next part of the track. No overtaking through the yellow flags.
Must be this lap.
They've got an issue with their car. They're going to be slow.
Is Ocon in front of me? I don't think so. 5 tenths a lap. He's on medium tyres though. In theory, he should be catching me because mine are going off.
Let's use overtake and burn off some of this energy.
I'm saving it, mate. When I need it.
Keep an eye on that gap ahead, please. 7.9 seconds.
How come they're getting further away?
We're approaching the pit window and you're going to be on mediums.
The pit stop's where I lose it. Time, I mean. Mainly driving up to the pit limiter line and coming out of the actual pits. They're all in the pits now.
Okay, Ralph is in the pits. Ralph is in the pits now. Okay, so the gap to the car ahead, 8.9 seconds.
Oh, here we go.
Piastri stopping now. Okay, the pit window's open, so let's box this lap, box this lap.
Tyres still feel quite good though, actually. Alright, here we go.
No tyre concerns at the moment, just focus on the driving.
Thank you.
go now. Come on. Perfect job from you and the crew there, mate. We're delighted with that. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Let's go.
Lost one position. Alonso, cheeky bugger. Slowly but surely catching him. Perez on my arse though. I've hardly got any battery left.
Teammate
by 19.9 seconds. They all pitted before I did though, so that means my tyres are not as old as theirs, so hopefully that'll come into play towards the end of the race. Alonso is hauling ass at the moment. Get my elbows out here. Oh no. Out well. To go defensive.
3.5 seconds. Thank you.
ERS isn't bloody recharging very quick, is it?
Okay, gap ahead is 4.2 seconds.
Is that coming down or going up? I can't remember what he was before.
Catching the car ahead, well done, but be aware these tyres need to get us to the end of this race.
He's getting away, we're not catching him at all. I'll save this ERS until the latter few laps of the race and hopefully their tyres will go off.
Gap to the car in front is 3.5 seconds.
At least we're pulling away from Stroll, that's the main thing. So we can focus on looking forwards. Although we're not really achieving much going forwards. Because Alonso is hauling ass.
Five laps of fuel remaining.
I think my ERS must need changing because I've got that orange thing in the bottom right hand corner. I'm pretty sure all the other components are kind of alright really, but ERS doesn't seem to be recharging hardly at all. Right, I think Alonso's tyres are starting to go off because we've just made up a second on him. Oh no. And we've just lost half of that. We need to push now.
You've lost some time to the car behind. Okay, gap to the car ahead is 2.3 seconds. Okay, we've got 4 laps of fuel remaining.
It's not gonna happen. Battery's dead. It's not going to happen. I'm going to have to set off a 9th.
Final lap, final lap. Push, push.
Oh, don't push that much, do I? Back well. Oh, I moved up one place. To be honest, I'm quite happy with that. And we didn't have to use any flashbacks during the race, except for T1 lap 1. Complete concentration, but they persevered to take the win here today. So at least we still got some points. That'll ding dang do.
The track temperatures we saw today suited their car. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature, and the driver did a great job managing that as well.
Well, Mercedes are on top form once again after an excellent race weekend. It's great
well
to see
done,
them
Lewis.
Up on that podium once again.
That dickhead on the right. Surprised they didn't put the animation in where he throws the trophy up in the air. leveled up.
And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. Well, that lead at the top has somewhat shrunk today. So then, Natalie Pinkham, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Dotty.
Well, for me, it's got to be Lewis Hamilton. The multiple world champion may be the obvious choice at this point, but he's certainly a driver deserving of his great reputation.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. It was a tough race for our championship.
Oh, we didn't move up one place. We started in ninth. Oh well, in theory, you can't really ask for anything else. We started in ninth. Piastri, I mean, in theory, like, Piastri was behind us and he finished 7th, so that's where we should have finished, really. At least 7th. But nothing lost there, really, so I'm happy with that. It's quite a difficult track. A nice track. I love Zandvoort. So he didn't get any points by the looks of it. Bit of coin. I can't remember where the next race is.
Our margins are looking good right now. I think we've got room for some more investment.
Monza. But we are going to leave it there. Quite happy with the... Let's have a look at the standings. Ooh, that car didn't look so good. Well, the engine's on 41%. MGU's not too bad. That's getting near the... near disaster. That's only on 13, 24. Don't forget we've got 11 races left yet. That's fine. We're on our fourth gearbox. That one's knackered. And they're on the cusp of being knackered. So it looks like before the end of the season we're going to have to be taking a penalty for a new gearbox. Alright, so it's that that's causing the issues. That's the only bit that's oranged out, if you like. Well, we won't fit it yet. Customization, what's that? Oh, there must be some new stuff. Not interested. So yeah, we're only got 2 points from that last race, but we're still in seventh. Lucky sevens. Matey boy still hasn't got any points yet, I don't think, no. But we're fifth in the Constructors by a fair old good stretch. 20 points. Not too far behind Aston Martin, but how are they doing? 8th and 10th. So our best possible finish is 4th. Aston Martin are our main rivals, if you like. But we haven't done too bad so far. Well, we started off bad, obviously, because the car was even worse than it is now. So our first points race wasn't until Catalunya in Spain. And then we started having some good results. We got our first win at Spa in the main race. I can't remember what I got in the sprint, but must have been alright. for us to finish first in the race. We must have had a decent grid spot. So yeah, on to Monza next. And I suppose, in theory, Monza is the next real-life race after this weekend. So in theory, I've kind of caught up with real life. So I might actually leave that. Well, we'll watch this stream back. If it's an absolute dog... I might not bother. But if it's at all watchable, without it skipping too much of the race, because I know it'll cut out and you'll miss like X amount of seconds. I mean, I can see it's not working now, because I'm moving and what have you, but it's not moving on the screen. Crock of shit. In this day and age, you can't get decent internet. But anyway, short one tonight, guys. I hope you've been able to watch it. And if you have enjoyed yourself, please hit that thumbs up. Much appreciated. And internet dependent, hopefully, I'll see you at the next one. I'll be seeing you.